Hi, this is Tim and welcome back to another video. Today we're doing something quite special and a little bit different. Today we're going to do a first reaction to the new Pearl Jam album, GIGATON. So let's get straight into it. GIGATON. It's quite Floyd-y. That intro. Those keys. That's... Oh. Oh yeah. That's how you start an album. Love the drums. Just great drums, great drums. Great vocal performance. Ooh, that's a nice change. Just great drumming. Killer. Keys as well, loads of keys. Lovely, lovely chorus. Yeah, this is good. This is good. Yeah, no, that's a good way to start an album. Interesting change. A really nice change of I think that feels like a modulation in key as well. His voice is incredible. It feels like he's done a lot of work over the last 5 or 6 years. Or he's just rested it a lot. Oh, lovely. Those little guitar harmonic things going on. Really, really nice. Cool. Okay, so the next two tracks on the album, Dance of the Clairvoyants and Super Blood Wolf Moon, we've all heard those before. So we're going to skip straight onto track 4, which is Quick Escape. Let's have a listen. Loads of weird noises. I like it. Weird riff. Lovely. Sounds like 1950s, that kind of rockabilly sound. Bass. Vocals, just great. The drumming as well, just class. Oh. Oh, yes! God, that's killer, man. That is killer. Love that guitar. experimented with a lot of new sounds. I really, really like it. And that bass! A great verse with just that rolling, thumping bass and drums. And a chorus! Yes! I like this. This is good. I'm expecting a big guitar solo. Piano line. Yeah. Solo? There you go. Maybe. No, alright, no. I was expecting a big solo there, but. I do, I love that chorus, man. That is kick ass. Coming! Guitar solo? No? Yeah, there we go. Ooh! Lovely little flourishes. Interesting effect on that. That's... Oh, a bass! He's getting on it too. I love it, love it. Classic, that's classic Mike McCready. Drumming, just the drumming. Killer. I love that. That was spot on. Let's go to the next one. Lots of really cool sort of keyboards and synth sounds. It really shows growth and stuff. I love it. I really like it. I feel like this could be an opener. This will be, they'll open a few shows with this. They'll open a few shows with this. In the rings of a tree, if your heart still beats free. So Pink Floyd. So Pink Floyd. So many of those weird synth keyboard things going on and just very minimal. When you want to run. His voice just sounds on, just on form. Really, really clear and crisp. Doesn't sound like he's struggling. The Avocado album, it sounded like he was really, really struggling. This just sounds... It sounds on it. Nice vocal layering as well. Just really sparse guitars as well. Just like... I love all that delay stuff that Mike's doing. Big drums as well, big drum sound. It really feels like a return to form as well. Although saying that, Lightning Bolt was a great album, and as was Backspacer. Nice harmonies. It's nice. It's a nice little... You're definitely an opener. Or even maybe a closer. Close one of the first sets or something. Yeah, it's cool. It's cool. I like that. I like it. I like it a lot. Cool. Okay, 7 o'clock. So many weird noises. I'm really interested to see how they do this live. Nice melody. Really nice, strong melody, that is. Doesn't feel like a band that have been around for coming on 30 years. Still feels fresh and interesting, which is good. And you wouldn't think they were nearly 60. I love it. Really, really, really enjoying it. Feels a bit Bruce Springsteen, has this kind of driving, kind of open road kind of feel to it. But yeah, spacey and echoey. It's cool. Ooh. I didn't think it was going to go there. Very, very original. It's a really unusual change. It feels like a key modulator, key change or something. Very good, very clever. Clever writing. Back to that driving kind of. Yeah, this is very, very strong. 7 o'clock. I think this and Quick Escape, so far the standouts. Really, really like this. Really good. Okay. Never Destination. Again with the weird noises. Very Who. Who?
Mm-hmm.
Punky, Clash, Who. Yeah, yeah. Fun. Sounds fun. Sorry if I'm shouting. I've got it. I'm not here. Love that. Yeah, that's cool. It's cool. Solo. It's always better to have solos. That stone part at the back. Sorry, my memory card got full, so I've got to stop that. So Never Destination was the last one. I think that was a great track. Brilliant. So we're going to move on to Take the Long Way. Nice, good riff. Cool, it's good. Kind of what you come to expect from Pearl Jam. Drumming, good, first class drumming. Kind of odd. Good, nice chorus. What a riff! What's that? Ooh, yes. Great vocals, man. Harmonies, everything on this is brilliant. Killer, killer. All right, time is of the essence. We got to move on quickly. Okay, buckle up. Buckle up. It's got to be fast. No? Oh. That's nice. Oh, okay. I was expecting something fast and energetic again. Kind of like a lullaby. Yeah, it's all right. I don't know what to feel about this one. Let's see where the chorus goes. Oh, that was it. Okay. I'm not as keen on this one. There's not much of a melody there for me. Nothing to sort of grab onto. Let's see where it goes. Thank you. Yeah, I'm not feeling this one really. Let's skip on. Comes and goes. Nice guitar. Very Vedder, very Eddie. This is where I find out it's actually Stone. High or low, where'd you go? Are you stuck in the middle of spectral invisible goals? I'm here juxtaposed. It sounds like images of angels. What does it sound like? Just that first change. I'll wait for it to come out again. Sounds like something I've heard before of theirs. It's nice. Nice little groove. Nice, lovely guitar playing. This change here coming up. Up there. What does that sound like? Thin Air on Binaural. It sounds a bit like that. Sounds very Dylan, very Bob Dylan. Sounds like a lot of the stuff that was off the Lost Dogs album as well. It's not a criticism, it's not a bad thing. This feels like a very kind of songwriter's song. Sadness comes with a bitter sea of tears. Nice. Yeah, that's cool. Good. Moving on. Moving swiftly on. Retrograde. More of those noises. Those noises are back. Nice. No, nice little 12 string. I feel like this is going to be epic. I just love that there's so many different noises, so many different sounds and textures and layers. It just really shows a lot of growth. Well, you'd expect that after 30 years. Where are we going? Yeah. Oh. Lovely. Lovely. Yeah. Yes. That is just quality songwriting. Absolutely quality. Lovely playing. Mike's playing is great on this album. Everyone's on form. Momentum. Yeah, this is. It's gonna take much more than just great. Clever songwriting. Love that chorus, man. It picks up, the pickup as well. It's just brilliant. Times are better than right now. Love it. Love that one. Love that one. That's going to be a fan favourite, I think. All right, let's move on to the last one. We're running out of time. River Cross. River Cross. Boom Casper. Bass. Not what you'd expect. The other side is done now. Haunting. Nice keyboards. Sorry, I know I'm not talking much. I'm just trying to absorb as much as I can. Stops recording and then I gotta start it again. That's why there's little jumps and cuts and stuff. Beautiful. The vocal sounds a little bit breathy in this. Like there's no oomph there, I don't know. Maybe that's what he was going for. I want this dream to last forever. A wish denied to lengthen our time. Yeah. I wish this moment was never handed. Very Neil Young. It's a Neil Young kind of vibe. Let it be. You can hear though all those influences from the 60s and 70s just pouring through this album. But also not sounding like them, not ripping them off, just definitely their own sound. So there we go. That was an experience. I really, really enjoyed listening to that album. Standout songs are Quick Escape, 7 O'Clock, Retrograde, Never Destination, just quality songwriting. And then there was only really one song, Buckle Up, that I didn't really sit with me. Maybe it's a grower, we don't know. But yeah, now I'm going to have to get learning these songs and then, because I can feel like people are going to want to learn them, especially that guitar solo in Quick Escape. Yeah, that was killer. And that bass as well, the bass was fighting with it for a solo. It was cool. It was really cool. I really, really enjoyed it. This is going to, it's going to be a grower. So, yes, I'm loving it. Loving it. Back, it's like 7 years, I think. 7 years? 7 years since an Al Pearl Jam album. Worth the wait. Thank you. Thank you for stopping by. Thank you if you made it all the way to the end of this video. Thank you. If you want to see some more, if you want to see some guitar tutorials on this album or any other albums that are kicking around the world, just subscribe down there, and give the video a like, and I'll see you on the next video. I'll catch you later. Thank you. Bye-bye.